expression for resistors connected in series. Let us try to understand what is meant by series combination. Suppose I have three wires, wire A, wire B and wire C, and these three wires are to be joined end to end in succession, that is one after the other, such that there will be only one common point between two wires. Is it possible? Yes. So suppose I consider this as wire A. This is the end point of wire A. I connect wire B with this end point. So this is wire B and this is wire C. So you see, between these two wires there is one common point. Between these two wires there is one common point. So here what have we done is that we have connected three wires in succession, that is one after the other, such that there is one common point between two wires. Such a combination is called as series combination. In a similar manner, we can have resistors or resistances connected in succession. For example, this is one resistance. I connect another resistance along with it. I connect another resistance along with it. So here I have connected three resistors in succession or in series, such that there is one common point between the two resistors. So these two resistors have one common point. These two resistors have one common point. Now what is the purpose of connecting the resistors in series? Whenever the resistors are connected in series, suppose I name this resistor as R1, this is R2 and this resistor is named as R3, and I connect an ammeter in the circuit and I have a key, and this key is connected to a battery. Now what will happen is, when the circuit is closed, here you can see the key is closed now. When the circuit is closed, current will start flowing through the circuit, isn't it? And when the current starts flowing through the circuit, you see the current will start from the positive terminal. It will flow through the ammeter. It will flow through resistance R1, R2 and R3. So what happens here is that when the resistors are connected in series, same amount of current flows through the circuit, isn't it? Same current will flow through resistor R1, same current will flow through resistor R2 and same current will flow through resistor R3. So whenever the resistors are connected in series, current I is the same. Got it? But whenever we have to measure voltage, that is potential difference, in a series combination, the potential difference differs across each resistor. Suppose I want to measure the potential difference across the resistor R1. So what I have to do is, I have to connect a voltmeter here across the resistor R1. And this voltmeter will measure the potential difference V1 across the resistor R1. I remove this connection and I connect the voltmeter across the resistor R2. So this voltmeter will measure the potential difference V2 across the resistor R2. If I want to measure voltage across this resistance, again I have to connect a voltmeter and I measure potential difference V3 across the resistor R3. So in a series combination, current flowing through each of the resistor is the same, but the potential difference V across each resistor is different. So across R1, our potential difference is V1. Across resistor R2, potential difference is V2. And across R3, the potential difference is V3. Another interesting thing that you will notice in the circuit diagrams is that whenever an ammeter voltmeter is connected in the circuit and ammeter is always connected in series. But when a voltmeter is connected in the circuit, a voltmeter is always connected in parallel with the resistances. Now let's try to understand why a voltmeter is connected in parallel. We know that in a series combination, current I flows through the circuit and the current is the same. The reason is that there is no pathway for the current to branch out. The current will flow through each of the resistor, which is going to be the same. We also know that a voltmeter is used for measuring the potential difference across any two points. Why is a voltmeter connected in parallel with the resistors? It is because a voltmeter has its own high resistance. A voltmeter has its own high resistance. What is the work of the voltmeter? It measures potential difference or voltage. Now consider that instead of connecting in parallel, if a voltmeter, suppose instead of ammeter here, a voltmeter had to be connected in series, then the voltmeter wouldn't have allowed the current to flow through the circuit. So, whenever a voltmeter is connected in parallel, there is some or absolutely no current flowing through the voltmeter. So, the current which is flowing through each of the resistances is possible. Now, let us try to understand why an ammeter is to be connected in series with each of the resistors. So here, these are the resistors and the ammeter is connected in series. So when the ammeter is connected anywhere across the circuit, anywhere here across the circuit, it is called as a series. It is said to be connected in series. Now, ammeter is a device which has its own resistance, but an ammeter has a low resistance of its own. So if an ammeter had to be connected in parallel, suppose here instead of voltmeter, suppose we had to connect an ammeter in parallel, then what would have happened is that all of the current would have flowed through the ammeter. The current would have started here from the positive terminal. It would have come to this point. It would have flowed through the ammeter. So all the current would have flowed through the ammeter. Why? Because the resistance is very, very low. So in order to avoid this, an ammeter is always connected in series. So let us see the definition of resistors in series. If we have a number of resistors, which are joined end to end such that same current I flows through each of them. Current flowing through each of them will be same in succession, then the resistors are said to be connected in series. I repeat the definition of resistors in series. If a number of resistors are joined end to end so that same current flows through each of them in succession, then the resistors are said to be connected in series. So let us see how to derive the expression for resistors in series. But before that, we are going to see the circuit diagram for resistors in series. So what is a circuit diagram? Here you can see, I have connected. So now let us derive the expression for resistors in series. But before that, we will see the circuit diagram for resistors in series. So here you can see, I have drawn three resistors in succession or in series, and these three resistors are connected in series between two common points C and D. And let the three resistors connected in series be R1, suppose this resistor is R1, this resistor is R2, and this resistor is R3. So these resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected between two common points C and D, such that the current flowing through each of the resistor is going to be the same. I have connected an ammeter in series along with the resistors R1, R2 and R3. There is a key which is connected along with the ammeter, and the key is connected to a battery. Okay, so now I'm going to mention the terminals. This is the positive terminal of the battery, the negative terminal of the battery. The positive terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal of the ammeter. Then the current flows here. Now we have to record potential difference across each of the resistor R1, R2 and R3. So as I told you that in series combination, since there is no branching of current, the current flowing is same, but the potential difference across each of the resistor will be different. So if we connect a voltmeter across R1, the potential difference across R1 will be V1. If we connect a voltmeter across resistor R2, the potential difference will be V2. And if we connect a voltmeter across resistor R3, the potential difference will be V3. Okay? I have to show the direction of current in the circuit. The current will start from the positive terminal. So this will be the direction of flow of current in the circuit. Am I clear? So this is the circuit diagram for resistors which are connected in series. So let's start with the derivation. Here in the description part, we are going to give a short introduction where we are going to mention three resistors R1, R2 and R3. To be connected in series between two common points C and D. So see, I have written down the statement. Consider three resistors R1, R2 and R3 connected between two common points C and D. Suppose I is the current which is flowing through the circuit and V is the potential difference which is connected. V is the potential difference. Okay. Now, as I said, the voltage will change across each resistor. So let the potential difference or voltage across resistor R1 be V1, isn't it? I have taken V1 as a potential difference. Across resistor, let the voltage be V2, and across resistor R3, let the voltage be V3. Okay. Now, if I want to calculate the total resistance of the circuit, the total resistance of the circuit is called as the equivalent resistance or the effective resistance. So, for that I'm going to write, let the total resistance of the circuit be, since we are considering series combination, the total resistance, I'm going to mention it as RS, total resistance, or you call it as effective resistance. So the total resistance of the circuit will be equal to RS. Now in series combination, the total voltage of the circuit is equal to the sum of the individual voltage drop across each of the resistor. That is, in series combination, if I want to find out the total voltage of the circuit, the total voltage will be denoted by V. This total voltage will be is equal to sum. Sum means what? Plus. Sum of voltage drop across each of the resistor. What is the voltage drop across R1? V1. Voltage across R2? V2. Voltage across R3? V3. So, if I take the sum of the voltages, which is called as a voltage drop across each of the resistor, the total voltage in the circuit V will be is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now children, here I am going to apply Ohm's law. So, by Ohm's law, I know that V, that is the total voltage of the circuit V is equal to, what is Ohm's law here? Ohm's law is V is equal to IR. If you remember, we have done it in one of the previous videos that the current which is flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference which is applied across its ends. So I will be is equal to, if you remove the proportionality sign, 1 upon R into V, where R is the resistance of the conductor. So I into R will be is equal to V. So that's what I have taken. V is equal to IR. So in this case, this is the total voltage of the circuit. I is the current which is the same across all the three resistors. But here this is the total resistance that I'm going to take. So R will be is equal to RS, that is the total resistance of the circuit. Then we are going to make substitutions for V1, V2 and V3 also. So V1 means voltage across resistor R1, that is V1. This voltage drop across resistor R1. So see, we are having the formula V is equal to IR, isn't it? So V1 will be is equal to IR1. I will remain as it is. Why? Because the current flowing through each of the resistor is the same. So I will remain as it is. But across the voltage across the resistor R1. What is voltage across resistor R1? V1. And what is the resistor that I am taking? R1. So V1 will be is equal to IR1. Similarly, if I take voltage V2 across R2, if I apply Ohm's law formula, V2 will be is equal to IR2 and V3 will be is equal to IR3. Okay. Now let me take this equation of total voltage across the circuit V as V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now substituting the values in equation number 1. So substituting the values in equation number 1. What is equation number 1? V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. What is V equal to? IRS is equal to. What is V1? IR1. What is V2? IR2. Plus, what is V3? IR3. So, IRS will be is equal to I common in all the three terms. R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now, I will get cancelled from both the sides. So, total resistance in series across the circuit RS will be is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is when the three resistors are connected in series. For example, suppose if I say in this particular combination, R1 is equal to 2 ohms, R2 is equal to 2 ohms, R3 is equal to 2 ohms. So, what will be the effective resistance of the combination of these three resistors R1, R2 and R3? RS will be is equal to 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is equal to 6 ohms. Did you get it? So, RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now, here I have connected only 3 resistors in series. So, if we have n number of resistors connected in series, we get RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. I said there are n number of resistances plus Rn. So there could be 10, 20, infinite number of resistances. So this is the expression for resistors in series. So this is the expression that we are going to take. RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the formula that we get for resistances come connected in series if there are 3 resistors which are connected in succession, one after the other in series. And if there are n number of resistors, the expression becomes RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus dash 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 plus Rn. Now let us study the laws or characteristics of resistances in series. The first law states that the current flowing through each of the resistance is the same, isn't it? That is a very first remark that I have made. In a series combination, since the resistors are connected in series, the current does not get bifurcated or the current does not get branched. Therefore, current flowing through each of the resistance or current flowing through each of the resistors will be the same. Second, total voltage. How did we represent the total voltage? Total voltage is V. Across the combination, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the combination of the three resistors. So if I want to find out the total voltage of the circuit or the total voltage of the combination V, it will be is equal to sum of voltage drop across each of the resistor, that is V1 plus V2 plus V3, sum of voltage drop across each of the resistor. What is the voltage drop across R1? V1. Voltage drop across R2? V2. Voltage drop across R3? V3. So the total voltage across the combination is equal to sum of voltage drop across each of the resistors. This is our second law. The third law states that the voltage drop is proportional to the resistance. So here the voltage is proportional to the resistance of the circuit. That is, if you increase the voltage, the resistance will increase. If you decrease the voltage, the resistance will decrease. So the voltage across each of the resistor is proportional to the resistance of the circuit. Then equivalent resistance, how do we denote equivalent resistance in series? Rs is equal to sum of the individual resistances. So in case if I have three resistors in series, Rs, that is the equivalent resistance, will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is our next law, that equivalent resistance is equal to sum of individual resistances across each of the resistors. The next law states that the equivalent resistance is larger than the largest individual resistance. Now I have taken an example here. I have said that let the resistance R1, in this case, be 10 ohms, let resistance R2 be 8 ohms, and resistance R3 be is equal to 8 ohms. So what will be the equivalent resistance in this case? Equivalent resistance Rs will be is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, which is equal to 10 ohms plus 8 ohms plus 6 ohms, which is equal to 24 ohms. So total equivalent resistance is equal to 24 ohms. Now you will find that the equivalent resistance Rs is greater than any of the individual resistance. Like for example, Rs is greater than R1, Rs is greater than R2, Rs is greater than R3. So if the equivalent resistance is 24 is greater than R1, that is 10. Equivalent resistance 24 is greater than R2, that is 8 ohms. And equivalent resistance 24, Rs, is greater than R3, that is 6 ohms. So what is the next law? That equivalent resistance is larger than any of the individual resistances. And the sixth law states that series combination is used to increase the effective resistance of the circuit. See, the effective resistance is increasing because here we are adding up the resistances, the number of resistances that we have, R1, R2, R3, Rn. So when we are adding up the resistances, what happens to the effective resistance? The effective resistance increases in the circuit. So this combination is used to increase the effective resistance of the circuit. Laws of resistances in series, or characteristics of resistances in series. First law, current through each resistance is the same. Second, total voltage across the combination is equal to the sum of voltage drop. Third, voltage drop across any resistor is proportional to the resistance. Fourth, the equivalent resistance is equal to the sum of individual resistances in the circuit. Fifth, equivalent resistance is larger than the largest individual resistance. And sixth, this combination is used to increase the effective resistance of the circuit.